El día de hoy vamos a seguir con el Life of Strange Before the Storm. Y bueno, justamente la habíamos dejado aquí, en el que por fin hemos acabado el episodio 1. Y como podéis ver, pues no acabó muy bien. Al final pasó el incendio porque Rachel se cabreó, ya que vio pues su padre que estaba con una chica, no sabemos quién es. Se enfadó y básicamente quemó la foto. ¿Y qué pasó? Pues que le pegó una patada a una papelera y ya veis el resultado. Entonces, en el vídeo de hoy, en el vídeo anterior ya habíamos acabado el episodio 1, ¿vale? Como podéis ver, en este juego son episodio 1, episodio 2, episodio 3 y luego ya tendríamos este, que este sería el episodio bonus. Pero vamos, básicamente la historia se acaba aquí, en el 3. Entonces, en el vídeo de hoy vamos a empezar directamente con el episodio 2. Y bueno, vamos a ver qué tal el vídeo de hoy y espero que os guste muchísimo. Y vamos adelante. Vamos a ver qué nos encontramos y cómo sigue la historia. Uy, esto no me gusta, ¿eh? Estamos en el despacho del director Wells, sí. Y ahora viene Chloe, ¿cómo no?
Miss Price, how good of you to join us.
I'm so sorry we're late. My shift ran late at the diner and then just sorry.
Let us proceed. One of you here is new to the Blackwell disciplinary process. And the other is all too familiar with it. Blackwell's code of conduct is built upon a foundation of mutual respect meant to foster an environment conducive to education and enrichment. When that respect is violated...
Reality check time. Yesterday did actually happen. I ditched school with Rachel Amber, and then Rachel really did start that fire. And that was after we actually agreed to run away from here. Right?
Are you paying attention to me, Chloe?
What?
Miss Price, the last time we met, an agreement was brokered. Do you recall what that was?
A ver, yo no sé de qué trato están hablando, no tengo ni idea. Supongo que no diera problemas, es lo lógico.
Don't get in trouble again.
Trouble is merely the byproduct, Miss Price. What's at issue is your attitude. We agreed that you would rededicate yourself to becoming an exemplary Blackwell citizen.
We did?
In the event that you were unable or unwilling to do so, we also agreed that it would become pertinent to reassess your future status at the Academy. Despite all this, you engaged in the following actions yesterday. Insubordinate language. Witnesses saying you were involved in bullying Nathan Prescott.
The hell I was! I stood up for that little weirdo.
I suppose that's one interpretation of events.
Say what you will about my daughter, but she is not a bully.
Maybe you should be talking to Drew instead of me. You know, the guy who actually did what you're accusing me of?
Mr. North's situation requires sensitivity. It will be handled separately.
And Chloe's situation is less sensitive?
I do not discuss other students' situations. We are here to discuss your daughter and her actions.
Convenient.
A ver, ¿podemos calmar al director? Sí, vamos a calmar al director.
Principal Wells, I know this looks bad.
Thank you for your validation, Miss Price. May I continue? With your permission?
Sorry.
And yet, even with your prodigious disciplinary record, Miss Price, we needn't discuss any of it.
We needn't?
No, because you severed your relationship with Blackwell the minute you left school grounds without permission.
What does that mean?
It means... you forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe. I have no choice but to...
I made her do it.
What?
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 What? Yesterday was all me. My idea. I was having a bad day. I needed to blow off some steam, and I took it too far. Chloe tried to talk me out of it. I've been down that road, she told me. You're better than this. But I wouldn't listen. See, Chloe was afraid I'd get in trouble or hurt, so she came with me. But only to keep me safe. I'm just sorry you got caught up in it, Chloe. That you allowed me to drag you down to my level. Can you forgive me?
Yeah, sure. We're cool.
Thank you. I'll make it up to you. I promise.
Chloe, is this true?
It's true.
Totally not true. She really is an amazing actress.
Miss Price?
Fine, yes. It was her idea, but it's not like she kidnapped me. We were in it together.
Miss Amber, based on what you've just told me, I have grounds to punish you. Are you sure what you've told me is the truth?
Yes.
This can't be the full story, Rachel.
Ray.
Just to be clear, Miss Amber, you're sure Chloe Price didn't coerce you or...
Coerce her?
I'm just trying to get to the bottom of why someone like Rachel...
Oh, I think we're clear, Principal Wells. Someone like Rachel, but not my daughter.
Excuse me?
Do you have a list of students you assume the worst about?
Mejor voy a estar callado, no voy a decir nada, ¿vale? Que siga.
You have no right to treat Chloe this way. This is because she's on financial aid, isn't it?
Let's all just calm down.
After everything she's been through in the last 2 years, you should be ashamed of yourself.
Miss Price.
Mrs. Price.
Mrs. Price, I appreciate your position, but I assure you, it is only your daughter's past behavior that has led us here today.
I understand, Mr. Wells. There is no doubt that Chloe's behavior must improve. But given what we've just learned about the negative influence she was under, I hope you will allow her just one more chance.
Miss Amber, I am as surprised as I am disappointed in you.
I understand.
This being your first infraction in no way reduces its severity. Still, we will not be suspending you at this time. But you have squandered our trust. You will no longer be my administrative assistant first period. And you will no longer be involved in Blackwell's performance of The Tempest.
No.
What? Are you insane?
Your discipline is still pending, Miss Price.
Ray, she loves that show. Since this is her first infraction, don't you think,
Amber, I don't tell you how to run the district attorney's office. Please, don't tell me how to run my school. There's a reason we have understudies for all circumstances. accidental and deliberate. I'm sure your understudy...
Victoria Chase.
Yes, I'm sure Victoria Chase will do fine.
That is such...
What was that, Miss Price?
Chloe is upset for her friend, but we are both grateful that she is not going to be unduly blamed for what happened.
There is plenty of blame to go around. Chloe's future at Blackwell will be discussed next. Unless you had something to add first, Miss Price.
A ver, podemos seguirle el rollo a Rachel. ¿Qué pasa? Que si le seguimos el rollo, se supone que se queda sin obra. Pero claro, si cargamos nosotros con la culpa, lo que ha dicho Rachel es mentira, entonces el otro puede pensar que era un papel. Incluso puede ser peor, porque encima si la cagamos, porque como podéis ver, ahora tocaría el juego este de... Tenemos que decir una frase y si la decimos bien, pues a la de 3 o a la de 2 hemos ganado. A ver, es difícil. Yo prefiero seguirle el rollo a Rachel.
No. Nothing to add.
I'm glad. Though Chloe may not have been the mastermind of yesterday's events, it was, as I prefaced, the proverbial last straw. In light of your many past transgressions, I have no choice but to suspend you for the rest of the year.
But it was the other girl's idea. She confessed.
And she will be punished accordingly, but that does not absolve Chloe of her responsibility. I am truly sorry it has come to this, but Chloe will have the chance for reinstatement in the fall. Her actions, beginning now, will be weighed heavily in that decision. Do you understand me? Both of you.
Yeah. I mean, as much as I ever do.
Chloe? We understand, Mr. Wells.
I will have Skip Matthews escort you to clean out your locker. You may wait outside my office until he arrives. That is all. Good day, Mrs. Price. Mr. and Mrs. Amber.
Ray.
Come on, Chloe.
Vale, pues empezamos bien el vídeo, Menuda bronca.
I'm sorry too. Meet me at the junkyard later? You bet.
I didn't get the chance to introduce myself. I'm Joyce.
Mrs. Price.
I'm Rose. This is James. I'm sorry we had to meet like this.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sure for you this is an unusual circumstance.
We really should be going. Nice to meet you.
Mom,
I'll see you in the parking lot.
Hey, Chloe. I'm supposed to walk you out.
Just you and me. Hey, Skip.
You know I was supposed to have today off, right?
Sorry that my totally fair and impartial hearing inconvenienced you, man. I don't really care about any of this shit. Except my secret stash. Might as well grab my emergency joint while I'm here.
Vale, a ver. ¿Esto de las firmas? Vale. El estuche, a ver qué hay. Ah, pues nada, miramos el estuche y ya.
You've served me well.
Vale, ha tirado el libro. Pues nada, otro libro más. Uy. Como nos vea el porro que está ahí, vamos bien, ¿eh? Vale.
Jackpot. Wait. What the hell? Damn it, Justin.
¿En serio? Hostia. Le roba el Justin, tío, qué asco.
Fuck every inch of this place. I wish I could tag it from floor to ceiling. But with Skip watching me.
Bathroom. Then I'm out. Cool?
Okay. But try to make it fast, will you?
No fastidies que va a empezar a pintar todo el baño. Hostia, pues sí. Vale, a ver, está chulo. Pero ahora cuando lo vean, ya verás tú. Claro, la victoria esta se ha quedado flipando. Vale, pues nada. Ahora sí o sí, para el juego empezamos el episodio 2. Vale. Vale, tenemos a David. Que aún no era el vigilante de seguridad, ¿vale? En la Academia Blackwell, aún no. Creo que ese es el que nos ha robado la mercancía.
Later, Skip.
Later.
Creo, no estoy seguro. Creo que ese es el Justin. Podría ser, ¿eh? Pero antes de ir ahí, ¿vale? Vamos a hablar con el otro.
Looks like David's.
Vale, a ver, Rachel. De verdad que nos vengaremos, vale. Uy, espera. Veo mensajes. A ver.
That I'll never send. At least Journal Max
vale,
won't abandon me the way Real Max did.
Sobre el incendio. Vale. Esto básicamente que se lío que flipas. Vale, a ver. ¿Dónde está el tío? Primero vamos aquí. Ah, no, pues este es el Elliot. Vamos a hablar con él.
Hey, Elliot.
What brings Chloe Price to school on a Saturday morning? Nothing good, I bet.
I was suspended.
Wait, really? Holy shit.
I know. I'm surprised it took this long, too.
Do you want a hug?
Venga, vale, a ver. Si el chaval quiere uno.
Okay. Thanks. Yeah, it sucks for Rachel, too. She was kicked out of the play because of me.
She'll live.
Harsh, man. Anyway, what are you doing here?
I thought I should come early to grab tickets. For the Tempest? You said we might see it together.
Oh, right. Good call.
Did you get my text about hanging out afterwards?
Yeah. I mean, I'm not really big on making plans, but maybe.
Cool. Sounds good.
I better go. My mom is waiting to stick her attack mustache on me. Her boyfriend. Don't worry about it. See you around, Elliot.
Vale, ya está. Ya hemos hablado con Elliot.
Yeah.
Nada later. Interesante, la verdad. Entonces ahora sí que sí, nos vamos directamente ahí. Con Joyce y David.
It's about damn time.
David, I'll handle it. Chloe, after today.
Chloe, your mother and I have been talking.
Can we do this later? I don't think I can handle another fight right now.
And who do you expect to handle things for you? Your mother?
This isn't a fight, Chloe. It's a conversation. Remember that.
I don't need a conversation. Not with Sergeant Asshat here. I just need some space.
Do not use that language with your mother.
A ver, okay, a ver. Es mi madre, ya, pero es que es tu madre. Se supone que no tienes que hablar así, entonces voy a tirar por él, okay.
Or what, David? What will you do?
You do not want to test me. Maybe if you try listening to me, instead of fighting me about everything, you might actually learn a thing or two.
What? How to be a soldier?
Soldiers put family and future above self and now. Getting kicked out of school? That's what losers do.
David, that's out of line. You weren't with us in there. Chloe was treated unfairly.
Now you're making excuses for her? Chloe needs to take responsibility.
I decide what Chloe needs, not you. Right now, what I need most of all is for the two of you to start getting along.
Chloe, I don't want to fight. I care about your mother very much. And you too. I'd like for us to start over. What do you say?
A ver, es una buena idea, la verdad. Y si habéis visto los anteriores vídeos de Life of Strange, el 1, la verdad que este tío es bueno. No os voy a dar spoilers por si no habéis visto el juego, ningún vídeo ni nada. Que os invito a que os paséis por el canal, ya si los veis todos. Este tío, os juro que es bueno. No os voy a decir el motivo, pero es bueno. Entonces vamos a darle una oportunidad.
Sure. Reset button pressed.
I am glad to hear it. From now on, I will be assisting your mother in a few areas. Like making sure that you are no longer abusing drugs or alcohol.
David, do you really think now is the right time?
Joyce, please. We must be a united front.
Mom.
Chloe, I'd like you to empty your pockets and place all your belongings on the trunk of the car.
What the fuck?
If we are going to start over, we have to know that you are not abusing drugs. If you're not, you should be eager for the chance to prove it.
Mom, you saw how I was treated in there. Now you want to treat me the same way? I don't need more discipline from you. I need my mom.
I know, Chloe. And I'm sorry, but David feels...
Joyce.
We feel this is the best way to start fresh.
Let's go, Chloe. Quit stalling.
A ver. Podemos obedecer. Que yo sepa, no cogió nada. Porque yo me acuerdo de que parecía que lo iba a coger y un papel, básicamente, que el otro, el Justin este, creo, le había cogido pues la mercancía. Entonces, no creo que tenga nada. O sea, yo creo que no hemos cogido nada ilegal. Ahora, que a lo mejor tiene cosas en el bolsillo del episodio anterior, ¿sabes? Entonces, como nos neguemos, la hemos liado y ya vamos mal, ¿sabes? Se supone que le hemos dado al botón reiniciar. Entonces yo le voy a dar a obedecer. Yo que sé, que no se saque todo de los bolsillos, ¿sabes? No sé, un poquito... ¿Veis un poco, macho? ¿Ves? Mira.
You know what sucks even worse than invading someone's privacy? Doing it for no reason.
You're awfully smug for someone who just got kicked out of school.
Oh, David. Chloe, I'm sorry. Can you forgive me?
A ver, sí, si es que la mujer no tiene la culpa, macho.
I forgive you. You were under a terrible influence.
I just worry about you, but that's no excuse.
Joyce, you can't start apologizing now. This will only encourage her.
That's enough out of you, David. We need to start treating each other better. And that means all of us. We need a new beginning. A new chapter. One that will involve the three of us together.
Well, what does that mean?
We both agree.
Hostia.
The best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
No fucking way.
Chloe, after everything that's happened, I'm at a loss. I need help.
Exactly. We need a firmer hand steering this ship.
Talk to me, Chloe. Tell me what you're feeling.
Vale, pues nada. Sé que la he cagado, sé que te has estado esforzando. Yo creo que sí, se ha esforzado, vamos a decírselo.
You're trying. I get it. I swear I do. And I've been making it harder for you. But this is not the answer.
It's the only answer I have, Chloe.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me. I'm sorry I took that for granted.
I'm not choosing anyone over anyone else. It's about the three of us having a home together.
It'll be better than you think, Chloe. Once everything's running smoothly, you'll see what a stable home can be like.
There is no home. Not if he's there.
Chloe.
Let her go. She'll come home as soon as her tantrum is over.
Vale. Pues bueno, se ha intentado pues darle al botón reiniciar, pero no ha salido nada bien, la verdad. A saber qué hubiera pasado. Yo creo que la cosa se hubiera puesto incluso peor. Porque luego encima nos hubiésemos negado y ¡buah! La que se hubiera liado.
How do you know which way is up when your whole life has been turned upside down? Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
Mira, el incendio aún sigue. Si os fijáis detrás, el incendio aún sigue, ¿eh? Estoy flipando. No sé si os suena de algo, ¿eh? Porque a mí esta camioneta me suena, ¿eh?
This thing is a mess, but maybe I can fix it.
Vale. Pues nada, a ver. Nuevo mensaje. Esto es importante mirarlo, así pues vemos cómo va la historia y nos vamos enterando de los detalles. Ahora básicamente están hablando de lo que ha pasado, ¿sabes? Vale, ahora vamos a mirar esto, los personajes. Ya hemos visto a casi todos, pero nos quedan estos dos. Y luego, pues, de escenarios nos quedan 3, 4, 5, 6, ¿vale? Vale, a ver, mis objetivos. ¿Cómo conseguir una batería? Ponerla en la camioneta, ¿vale? ¿Dónde hay una batería? Tiene que haber en un coche. Mira, aquí. Aquí, ya ves. Y tiene pinta el coche más o menos de nuevo. Ah, mira, ahí el botón. Ahora, palanquitas, que si no, no se abre.
Here we go, the pick of the litter.
Vale, la batería la tenemos. No me creo que con solo la batería funcione el coche. Porque eso tiene pinta de estar abandonado de hace unos meses, la verdad. Y podría ser que incluso años.
This thing needs more love than I can give right now. In the meantime, maybe I can spruce it up a bit.
Vale. A ver. Uy, mira, un mensaje. Vale. Pues bueno, mientras no viene al desguace, vamos a ver qué podemos hacer. Si esto va a haber que taparlo con una manta o algo, ¿eh? Luego el suelo oxidado, hay que buscar la forma de taparlo. Y luego he visto aquí una bombilla. Entonces, cuando hemos pasado para coger la batería, yo he visto que ponía en pequeño bombilla. No sé si vosotros habéis dado cuenta, pero yo sí. Entonces yo creo que ahí podemos coger eso. Entonces, mira. Es que justamente aquí, mira. ¿Veis? Bombilla. Bueno, claro, en verdad. A lo mejor no sirve, porque a lo mejor está fundida o 20.000 historias, pero bueno. Pero bueno, la bombilla la tenemos, oye. Pase lo que pase, al menos tenemos la bombilla. Vale, hay que buscar lo otro. Aquí no hay nada, ¿no? No, aquí ya no hay nada de nada. Vale, entonces vamos a buscar en la otra parte. Porque esto parece que no, pero es grande, ¿eh? Encima aquí hay de todo, que si chatarra y 20.000 historias y madre mía. Ponte tú a buscar aquí algo, ¿sabes? A ver qué hay aquí. Hostia, ¿qué es esto? Bueno, pues vale, mira, un accesorio. Creo que no hacía falta, pero vale.
No, not going over there.
Vale, aquí no hay nada.
It's all fun and games till this guy enslaves everyone.
Vale, esto supongo que será para tapar los asientos, ¿no?
This might make the perfect cover for that torn seat.
Vale, pues nos falta tapar el hueco ese. Que ya me dirás tú cómo tapas eso, ¿sabes? Podemos subir, ¿no? Ahora estaría gracioso que de repente este barco se cae, ¿sabes? Pero puedes subir, ¿no? Vale, pues hace falta una caja o algo para poder subir. Si no, verás. Mira, justamente... No, aquí no. Ah, no, que estas cajas no me sirven, es verdad. Hostia. Soy tonto. Ah, mira el palé. No, pero con esto sí puedes, ¿no? Por favor. Ay, gracias, menos mal. Es que al empezar os juro que... Digo que no, ¿eh? Que no tira, ¿eh? Ahora sí sube. Muy bien, ahora sí. Ahora hay que buscar la forma de... A ver qué encontramos para tapar el suelo ese oxidado. Y el incendio aún sigue, como podéis ver. No, sí, sí, el incendio no para, madre mía. Capó. Vale, una pintada. Vale, venga, una pintada. Ya que estamos, oye... Esto es como lo de Life of Strange, lo de hacer fotos. Pues esto es lo mismo. A ver, aquí... Tesoro enterrado. Es un barco. Vamos a poner eso. Una cosa, estamos subiendo muy alto, ¿eh? Yo no digo nada, pero hay que tener cuidado, ¿eh? Porque esto es antiguo y a lo mejor te subes y sin querer se cae todo, ¿eh? Y te pegas una hostia de las buenas. Vale, como podéis ver, pues nada. Esto básicamente era para ver el incendio. Entonces nada. Que baje. Sí, vamos a bajar porque yo aquí no veo nada. Vale, vamos a bajar y vamos a poner aunque sea esto. Y al menos ya tenemos algo. Venga. Vamos a poner primero el muñeco.
can hang here, but I get to pick the tunes. Okay? Good talk. While an escape hatch could be nice.
Vale, tener una escotilla de emergencia.
Cover over this massive hole.
Vale. Voy a salir. Voy a buscar como una escotilla de emergencia o algo así, ¿no? Vale, pero a ver, ¿dónde puede estar eso? Es que yo me pongo aquí a buscar y no encuentro nada. Vale, por aquí se puede ir. Luces de Navidad. Una alfombra.
Today. You begin an exciting new.
No me fastidies que con esto se arregla. A ver. Una escotilla de emergencia. A ver, eso es un suelo oxidado. Es que no me creo que con una mantita. Ya está. A ver, que a lo mejor sí, ¿eh? No lo sé, pero bueno. A ver. Ah, pues sí. Vale, es surrealista la verdad, porque ahora cuando llueva. Y el agua, pues va a ir para arriba, pero bueno, no creo que una manta lo absorba todo, pero bueno, da igual. Pero claro, el coche no arranca.
This thing looks like a rusted out shopping cart. Probably drives like one too. That's if it ever does drive, which seems questionable. Still, how sweet would that be? Yeah?
Bryce, it's Frank.
Oh. Hey, Frank. What's up?
Yeah, just checking in to see how you're doing.
Really?
No. Listen, we've got some business to discuss. Where can we meet?
What about? Oh, like drugs?
Bryce.
I'm hanging out in the junkyard, north of town.
The junkyard? That's great. Stay there, I'll see you soon.
Okay. And Frank, I'm not in trouble or anything, right?
I don't know. Did you do anything you should be in trouble for?
Like, in general, or to you?
I'll see you soon.
Vale, pues nada, va a venir Rachel y luego encima el Frank.
Vale.
Pues bueno, tenemos esto, ¿vale? Que podemos tocar el claxon, fumar, encender la luz, hacer una pintada y el muñeco. Pero lo que vamos a hacer va a ser, lo vamos a dejar aquí y ya en el siguiente vídeo directamente empezamos aquí. Y ya veremos pues qué pasa cuando venga Frank, porque parecía un tipo bastante raro. Porque algo pasa. Y luego a ver que también va a venir Rachel. A ver qué pasa. No os preocupéis porque eso lo veremos en el siguiente vídeo. Y bueno, esto es todo. Espero que os haya gustado muchísimo el vídeo de hoy. Apoya el vídeo con un like y nos vemos en el próximo vídeo. Hasta la próxima. Adiós.